We've got freaks, we've got sights to behold, we've got grotesque displays that are sure to turn heads and stomachs, we've got nightmarish creations that you don't want your kids to see. This installment is giving you a look at what awaits behind the curtain with the 10 creepiest circus freaks that shocked the world. It should be noted that these people aren't freaks in the sense of the word, but rather, they born with abnormalities. These people should be treated as just that, people. Number 1. Francesco Lentini, the three-legged man. As a child, Lentini hated his extra limbs and appendages. Doctors determined that because of their proximity to his spine, removal could have resulted in paralysis. Lentini was raised by his aunt after his parents refused to acknowledge him, and enrolled the young Lentini into a home for disabled children. Motivated after seeing children far worse off than him, Lentini gained a new appreciation for life. He did not only learn to walk, he also ran, jumped rope, rode a bicycle and even ice skate. His time at the home for disabled children was an experience he quoted for many years as his major motivation. In 1898, at the age of 8, Lentini arrived in America and became an instant sensation. He charmed crowds with his keen wit and sense of humor. He wowed audiences with his unusual agility as well. He had amazing control over his extra appendage. During performances, Lentini was well known for kicking a soccer ball about with the strange limb. His charm did not go unnoticed and a young lady, named Teresa Murray, soon took a liking to Lentini. The pair soon wed and together, they had 4 healthy children. Lentini continued touring until he died at the age of 78 in 1966. Number 2. Myrtle Corbin. Known as the four-legged woman, this moniker was slightly misleading. While at a glance, one could plainly see 4 legs dangling beyond the hem of her dress, only one pair actually belonged to her, the other set belonged to her dipygous twin sister. Born in Lincoln County in 1868, Myrtle's condition was incredibly rare. The tiny body of her twin was only fully developed from the waist down, and even then it was malformed, tiny, and possessing only 3 toes on each foot. Myrtle was able to control the limbs of her sister but was unable to use them for walking, and she herself had a difficult time getting around as she was born with a clubbed foot. She was said to be able to move her inner legs, but they were too weak for walking. Myrtle was a popular attraction with P.T. Barnum, and later with Ringling Brothers and Coney Island. Her popularity was likely linked to her showmanship. She would often dress the extra limbs with socks and shoes matching her own, and this gave her a truly surreal appearance. Myrtle was so popular that she was able to earn as much as $450 a week. At the age of 19, Myrtle married, and it was then that other aspects of her bizarre anatomy became evident. It seems that her twin sister was also fully sexually formed, thus Myrtle possessed 2 vaginas. She had 4 daughters and a son, and it has been rumored that 3 of her children were born from one set of organs, and 2 from the other. Whether this is true or not, it is medically possible. It was observed that both vaginas menstruated, thus indicating both were possibly sexually functional. Myrtle passed on May 6, 1928. Number 3. Bill Dirks. The Two-Faced Man. Bill Dirks was one of the most unusual of all freaks. He was called the man with 3 eyes and 2 noses and the Two-Faced Man. He actually didn't have 3 eyes, he really only had 1 eye, his other eye was damaged when he was born. His only real abnormality was one of the worst cases of a cleft palate ever seen. He painted his 3rd eye between both halves of his nose to look more disturbing. He had a fairly lengthy sideshow career. As a kid, his parents were ashamed of his looks and hid him from people, but the sideshow put him on display for people to see. He soon married another sideshow performer named Mildred, the alligator girl, and they became one of the world's weirdest married couples. Number 4. Ella Harper. The Camel Girl. Ella Harper was born with an unusual orthopedic condition resulting in knees that bent backwards. The nature of this unusual affliction is exceedingly rare and relatively unknown. However, most modern medical types would classify her condition in a very advanced form of congenital genu recurvatum, also known as back knee deformity. Her unusually bent knees, coupled with her preference of walking on all fours, resulted in her moniker of the Camel Girl. In 1886, Ella was the star of W.H. Harris's Nickel Plate Circus, often appearing accompanied by a camel when presented to audiences, and she was a feature in the newspapers of every town the circus visited. Those newspapers touted Ella as the most wonderful freak of nature since the creation of the world, and that her counterpart never did exist. We also now know that Ella died of colon cancer on 19th December 1921 in Nashville, Tennessee, and that she buried at Spring Hill Cemetery in Nashville. A simple gravestone marks her plot, but she is surrounded by family. Number 5. Mademoiselle Gabrielle. The Half-Woman. Mademoiselle Gabrielle was a legless marvel from the early 19th centuries. She was born in Basel, Switzerland in 1884 and began her freak show and exhibition career at the Paris Universal Exposition in 1900 as the Half-Woman. Mademoiselle Gabrielle possessed no legs and, according to a 1929 London Life article, she possessed no stumps whatsoever. Her torso finished just below the hip gracefully. Her figure was impressive and she accentuated her physical qualities and natural beauty with opulent Victorian garb and striking jewelry. Mademoiselle Gabrielle was independent and never complained of her condition. She firmly believed that she was no less a woman, despite being physically half of a woman. Mademoiselle Gabrielle attracted men in droves and married at least three times during her lifetime. First, she was married to a man with the surname of Hunter and lastly to a German gentleman. Due to these surname changes, her later history is difficult to trace and her eventual date of demise is currently unknown. Number 6. Grace McDaniels. The Mule-Faced Woman. Grace McDaniels, born in 1888, joined up with F.W. Miller's sideshow after winning an Ugliest Woman contest in 1935. She likely suffered from Sturge-Weber syndrome, a genetic condition which, in Grace's case, caused a large port wine-colored birthmark to thicken and distort the flesh of her face. Her condition was degenerative in nature and became worse with age. Shortly before her death, the fold of skin on her face hung more than 4 inches below her chin. Eventually, Grace had difficulty speaking due to the growth that enveloped her face. Grace was very sensitive about her appearance. She often tried to hide her disfigurement with makeup and then later, as her condition worsened, she took to wearing a veil. Grace also greatly disliked being called a freak, and hated the world's ugliest woman epithet used to advertise her appearances. She was often seen backstage covering her ears as not to hear the ballyhoo, the outside sales pitch, and the talker calling her a freak and detailing her deformities. However, as time went on and she began to make a good living with the sideshow, she became more and more comfortable with her condition and position in life. Eventually, she was able to convince the talkers and promoters to refer to her by the moniker she is known by today, Grace McDaniels, the Mule-Faced Woman. Later in life, Grace became a mother after a carnival handyman, allegedly named Johnny, impregnated Grace while he was intoxicated and was never heard from again. She had a son, Elmer. While Elmer was born a normal child, he grew into a physically and emotionally abusive alcohol and morphine addict who regularly stole from both Grace and from the sideshow, to pay off dangerous gambling debts. Acting as his mother's manager, it wasn't long before sideshows stopped hiring Grace due to the reputation of her son. The sad life of Grace McDaniels ended peacefully in 1958, and the true monster, her son Elmer, soon followed due to sclerosis of the liver. Number 7. Didier Cosuera. The Tree Man. Cosuera was perfectly normal for most of his life, but soon developed large warts that grew to resemble tree bark, branches, and roots. Because of the growths on his hands, he is unable to continue his carpentry work and lost custody of his two kids. He lives with his brother-in-law and is cared for by his entire family. He makes money by performing in a traveling sideshow. A few years ago, he was diagnosed with HPV and discovered his immune system was almost non-existent. He has had multiple surgeries to remove the warts and growths from his hands, feet, and face. Doctors said he had resigned himself to the debilitating illness which over several decades tragically came to cost him his family, job, and independence. Sadly, Deed Koswara, aged 42, died in hospital in Badung, Indonesia, on the morning of January 30, 2016 without ever realizing his dream of living to see a cure and returning to carpentry. Number 8. Robert Melvin. The Man with Two Faces. The moniker The Man with Two Faces has been given to many marvels during the history of sideshow. While few actually had two faces, Robert Melvin came pretty close. He was suffering from neurofibromatosis, a disorder that causes the spontaneous growth of fibrous tumors. The tumors that afflicted Robert completely distorted the features on the right side of his face. Robert Melvin, the man with two faces, never considered his appearance a handicap. In fact, once he entered the world of sideshow in 1949 at Coney Island, his appearance became a great advantage. Robert made a comfortable living with the sideshow both as an attraction and serving as the show accountant. During the off-season, Robert kept busy doing the books for a hardware store. He also enjoyed a minor film career, appearing as a sanitarium inmate in Sisters in 1973, along with fellow Marvel Bill Dirks, as a surreal demon in The Sentinel in 1977, and also in the documentaries Being Different in 1981, and I Am Not a Freak in 1987. He passed away on 9th November 1995 at the age of 75. Number 9. Schlitzie. The Pinhead. Well, it may appear that this moniker's head has been photoshopped. The true identity of the pinhead known as Schlitzie is still somewhat debatable. The most popular opinion, currently, is that Schlitzie was born as Simon Metz on September 10, 1901 in the Bronx. But, the true names truly isn't important. What is important is that Schlitzie's indomitable spirit was infectious, and still contributes popular culture. Schlitzie was born microcephalous, a condition characterized by an abnormally small and often pointed cranium. The condition often resulted in retardation, and Schlitzie himself was as cognitive as a four-year-old. Previous to Schlitzie, the display and exhibiting of pinheads was nothing new. In the 18th century, pinheads were often exhibited as a species apart from man, as the last members of an ancient race, usually Aztecs, and on occasion they were billed as being from another planet. For much of his career, Schlitzie was billed as female. This was mostly due to his dress-like attire, which was an attire choice based purely on his incontinence. While popular with crowds, Schlitzie's biggest fans were his colleagues and caretakers. To sum up, the reason for this fondness is difficult, but the wonderment Schlitzie held for the daily mundane, his childlike exuberance, his eternal innocence greatly influenced those around him. Schlitzie was a ray of sunshine, and his smile and unconditional love shined on all those around him. He was perhaps best known for his role in the Todd Browning cult classic film Freaks, though he also appeared in Island of Lost Souls, opposite Charles Laughton and Bela Lugosi. As a sideshow entertainer, Schlitzie was employed by every major name in the business. He continued to enchant crowds until his passing in 1971 at the age of 71. Number 10. Lionel. The Lion-Faced Boy. Stefan Bibrowski was born in Poland in 1890 to normal parents. He suffered from hypertrichosis, a rare genetic disease that covers the entire bodies of the subjects with a thick coat of fur. Only about 50 cases of the disorder have been documented since the Middle Ages. In the case of Lionel, 6-inch long hair covered his body. His mother believed his appearance was caused by the fact that she witnessed his father get mauled by a lion when she was pregnant. Lionel was discovered by a German man named Meyer when he was 4 years old and became famous throughout Europe, where he gained the nickname of Lionel the Lion-Faced Man. Far from being exhibited as a beast, he wore often the best clothes to show that under his hairs he was a literate and enjoyable person that spoke 5 languages. Lionel came to the US in 1901 and began appearing with the Barnum and Bailey Circus, then at Conet Island when he moved to New York. He retired in the late 1920s and moved back to Germany, where he died of a heart attack in 1932, and that's all. Thanks for watching, subscribe for more.